My main project is how can we use a material science approach to study the sense of touch? And our big question here within this study was, can we tell the difference between two materials that are equal in their bulk properties but differ at the surface by just one molecule? When you feel two different surfaces, say the wood versus the countertop that we see here, it's actually a mixture of different phenomena. The two have different thermal conductivities. So the way that heat flows from your body to those two surfaces is very different. If you touch a metal versus wood, they're both at room temperature, but the heat will flow towards the metal at a much faster rate and will create a sensation of it being colder than the wood. So you're feeling not only the thermal conductivity differences, but you're also feeling, on another scale, the roughness. So wood has all these little different granularities, whereas maybe the marble countertop at home is much smoother. What we've done here in this study is we've controlled for roughness and thermal conductivity. So both of our samples have that in common. They're both equally flat, as well as both feel fairly metallic. But the only difference here is the one molecule at the top. So what we're really probing is, can humans sense the difference between two materials that differ by their surface chemistry? So here, what we do in our studies, we have a human subject and we ask them, can you tell the difference between these two surfaces just with the sense of touch? And the test here is two of the surfaces are the same while one is different. And so we would ask them to point out, is it sample one, two, or three that is different than the other two? If you just look at these surfaces, you can't actually tell the difference. But what I would, you know, like you to do is examine those with your eyes. Could you tell me if there's any difference between them?
No, I cannot. I can't see a difference optically between them.
Okay. So then what we do is have you touch the actual samples and see if you could tell the difference between them just with your sense of touch.
Okay, I think it's number two. I think number one feels the most unlike two and three.
Okay. If we look here, the correct answers are, yes, you got them correct. The odd man out was number two in the first dish, and number one was different in the second dish.
Nice. Yeah, I felt like one of the slides definitely felt almost stickier or something than the other two. They were definitely uniquely identifiable, almost pretty obviously.
I think a lot of the motivation from this work actually comes from the push within virtual and augmented reality. We've done a really good job incorporating the eyes and the ears, so we can create three-dimensional environments and you can interact with them, but what you're failing to get from that experience is how the objects actually feel in reality. One of the things that's helped, say, virtual reality as well as high HD televisions come along is the ability to change the color of pixels. So here we're trying to figure out what are the minimum differences that we're actually sensitive to in the sense of through your skin. And the idea is that that would be the way to change the brightness, the hue, or the contrast, the intensity of the blue light that you feel through your eyes, but here with your hands. And so the idea is that we would be starting to figure out what are the actual tunable properties that we would need to recreate the red, green, and blue pixels, but for touch instead of your eyes.